Let's face it, one of the goals of every workout for almost everyone is to get a good pump. It's almost seen as the reward of having a good workout, and not to mention the fact that it feels amazing and you look extremely jacked in combination with some half-laden nighting, but you know. But sometimes you're unable to get a pump or don't know the factors that contribute to getting a pump or that make it easier to get a pump. Quick disclaimer, a pump is not an indicator of an effective workout, it's just an added benefit. So in this video, I'm going to go over how a pump occurs, the science behind it, and some of the fundamentals that can greatly increase the chance of getting a pump, and to make that pump even better. And I'm going to do my best to put these in order from the most essential factors to less essential factors, but keep in mind, everything I mentioned in this video will contribute to the pump. But first, how does a pump occur in the first place?
The greatest feeling you can get in a gym, or the most satisfying feeling you can get in the gym, is the pump. Blood is rushing into your muscles, and that's what we call the pump. It's like somebody blowing air into your muscle. It just blows up.
Alright, so now that Arnold has explained it in simple basics, let's go in depth. When lifting weights, you're creating small tears in your muscle fibers. Now, this is called muscle damage. Now, because of that damage, blood will flow to the area of the damage in order to repair it, thus making the muscle swell up. Now, this is what we would like to call the pump, or in scientific terms, hyperemia. Hyperemia means the increase of blood flow to the muscles of the body. Now, when you're breaking down muscle fibers, new, fresh, nutrient-rich and oxygenated blood will flow through your muscles to provide it with the building blocks needed for optimal recovery and growth. So how do we get a better, bigger version of this? Well, it's pretty simple. You create a better blood flow. Now, the most important thing besides everything, including supplements and nutrition, is water. Hydration is the most important factor when it comes to being able to get a pump in the first place. Now let's look at this in a very logical manner. If you look at dried fruit, for example, if something is dehydrated, it looks shriveled and empty. Your muscles will have the exact same if you don't hydrate them enough. Keeping yourself in a hydrated state is directly correlated with a greater blood volume, which makes it easier to fill your veins and arteries with blood to amplify blood flow and thus a pump when you're working out. Now you should especially focus on being well enough hydrated 1 to 2 hours before your workout. Now, of course, it's important to be hydrated all day long, but by focusing on drinking enough H2O before your workout, you will increase the chance of getting a good pump. Now, I recommend you to drink around 4 to 5 liters, which is around 1 gallon, of water per day. Now, don't drink too much in one sitting though, since water poisoning or water intoxication is a real thing and quite dangerous, so to be safe, spread it out throughout the day. Now, besides water intake, carbohydrates will be your next best friend. When eating carbs, your muscles will be storing glycogen. Now, glycogen is one of the energy sources used in producing power during a workout. Now, since glycogen is stored intracellular, it also influences muscle fullness due to the amount of water it starts drawing in, which also complements the fact you need to stay hydrated. To put this simple, high carb intake results in muscle fullness, low carb intake results in muscle flatness. It's difficult to get a pump when you have no glycogen, since, on the contrary, high glycogen levels increase the cell volume of the muscle, which allows for better, or more, blood flow if you look at it logically. High glycemic index foods have shown to increase muscle glycogen more rapidly than low glycemic index foods. This has to do with the time it needs to digest, simply meaning that high GI foods are digested faster and thus can be used as energy much faster than low GI foods. Now, be sure to eat a high carb meal before your workout, consisting of preferably high glycemic index foods such as, for example, rice cakes, brown or white rice, white potatoes, bananas, and so forth. Now, sodium also plays a huge role for a good pump. Now, for those who don't know this yet, sodium is a crucial mineral for your muscles. It's not the devil that people make it out to be, it's quite the contrary. Now, athletes need sodium for various reasons. Now, as an electrolyte, sodium is the positively charged ion on the outside of the living cell. So not intracellular, which means inside the muscles, but extracellular, which means outside of the muscles. It's responsible for regulating blood volume and blood pressure, which is the main reason it's important for a better pump. But besides that, it serves for other functions as well. During a high intensity set of any given exercise, blood pressure rises. This is a primary response of high intensity training. And when performing high performance exercises, the metabolism of the body is better served by a higher blood volume, since this translates into better oxygen and nutrient delivery to working cells, which is what happens when you create muscle damage. New blood has to flow through in order to repair the damage and build new muscle tissue. And what's also important is that a higher blood volume results in a more efficient removal of toxins that come from fatigue. So a low sodium intake obviously translates into a lower blood volume and over time will have a negative effect on your training. So to sum this up, a normal or slightly higher sodium intake will result in more blood flow and thus more nutritious blood that can be used to repair muscle damage and build new muscle tissue. A low sodium intake equals less blood flow and thus less nutritious blood that can be used to repair muscle damage and build new muscle tissue. Right, now the minimal physiological requirement for sodium is between 115 and 500 milligrams per day, depending on how much you sweat due to physical activity and whether the person is adapted to the climate they are living in. Now keep in mind, this is the minimum physiological requirement, which is pretty low compared to the adequate intake recommendation of 1.2 to 1.5 grams per day. So make sure to get at least some sodium in your diet. Don't be afraid to use it to give your meals a bit of flavor or eat foods that contain sodium in general. Now, if you're going to be using salt, I recommend using a salt like Himalaya salt, since it's a bit less processed than, for example, table salt. Now, referring to this study from the Journal of International Society of Sports Nutrition, nitric oxide levels measured after performing leg extensor exercises were severely higher in the group who consumed a NO boosting supplement compared to the placebo group. Both pre-leg extensor and post-leg extensor timeframes measured higher levels of blood flow. Now there are two supplements I'd like to cover, which are L-arginine and citrulline malate. Now while the two are both vasodilators, citrulline takes the spotlight in this one. Citrulline acts as an arginine precursor, meaning it's used in the production of arginine. Now arginine helps stimulate nitric oxide production, which acts as a vasodilator to open up blood vessels and increase blood flow to the muscle. So the logical thought would be to just take arginine, right? Well, not exactly. Arginine appears to take a different path when it comes to digestion, going through absorption in the small intestine and liver before being released in your general circulation. Now citrulline can bypass all of that and goes directly into the bloodstream, which acts a lot faster and will result in a more direct pump. Now there are also two types of citrulline. You have L-citrulline and citrulline malate. The only difference though is the addition of malic acid in citrulline malate, which serves as an important factor in the TCA cycle, which is one way your body produces energy, which means it increases blood flow and also subsequently oxygen and nutrients to where you're letting that blood flow to. Taking 8 grams of citrulline malate pre-workout results in an increased maximal grip strength, improved lower body explosive power, and potentially the amount of reps you can perform before reaching momentary muscular failure. Now, while this study has primarily been focused around lower body movements, it's safe to say it probably has the same effect for upper body movements as well. Now, it's also shown to reduce DOMS or delayed onset muscle soreness, so you can safely say it's in your best interest to start supplementing with citrulline malate. Now, temperature also plays a role in your blood flow. Now, ever notice that when it's hot outside or when coming out of a warm shower, you're more vascular? Well, that is because when your body temperature is high, your veins want to release heat and thus lay closer to the surface, which is your skin. Now, while the biggest result of this might simply be vascularity, it's pretty obvious that when your veins are showing, there's adequate blood flow and thus potential for a good pump. And that's also a big reason why a warm-up is important, since it promotes blood flow to the muscle, and as we now know, more blood flow equals more potential for a good pump. Static stretching has also shown to increase blood flow. Now, while this is a study done on rats, the same principle would generally and logically apply to humans. Static stretching lengthens a muscle, which would mean more room for blood to flow through the muscles. And as we now know from all the information mentioned in this video, combined with proper hydration, nutrition, and perhaps supplementation, you can get the sickest pump you've ever had. Alright, what's going on guys? Thank you guys so much for watching the video. Now I have put, you know, as I always say with every informative video, a lot of effort into this video, and this spot right here has pretty much been my living place for the past couple of 2 weeks or something. So a like would be highly appreciated to show your support, and I've been noticing a positive trend in support coming from these videos or on these videos, so really appreciate the support. If you have a suggestion for any informative topic that you would like to see a high quality informative video on, then please let me know in the comments down below. Subscribe to the channel for so much more content coming really soon. I'm out guys, and peace out. See you in the next one.